Hi, I'm Sanjay Puri, Principal Architect of Sanjay Puri Architects. We established in 1992 and we've just completed 25 years. So we're doing the entire gamut of architectural work, including a lot of private townships, residential projects, private bungalows, houses, institutes, schools, offices, entertainment centers, multiplexes. So this is one of those projects that happen really fast in the architectural world. You know, when you get a project in Bombay or in Delhi, it takes 6 to 8 months of gestation period. Then you do the design goes back and forth, then it goes into submission, then another 6 months waiting for approvals. So in this case, when we met GLA University, the director, what he told us was very brief, that we are in September. In April, my school goes for a holiday. And in June, the students come back. I need an 800-room hostel finished by then. Can you do it? So this is a university that's been existing since the last 10 years and it's operational. And we were actually given, you know, this small wedge-shaped plot like this in between existing hostels on this side, which are those very typical types, you know, you find like army barracks or like storage houses, they just repeat, repeat, repeat. And then on the other side also, there were repeat buildings like this. So one side was a boys' hostel, one side was a girls' hostel. There is a main road that runs through the campus. And right opposite this, this entire thing is a large playground. And what they were expecting us is to do something basically similar to this. So they took us around these hostels and said, you know, this is the way we do our hostels, central corridor, rooms on either side. And then what happens is when we went to these hostels, these buildings are like literally 20 feet apart. So at 20 feet, you're looking into the next hostel room bang opposite. And the other thing is that they wanted ground plus three only. So low rise so that it can be constructed fast. So what we did is we created something that is completely organic because we found there's too much structuring happening everywhere in this campus. So we made our buildings go like this based on the site. Then you had another building here and then yet another building here. So what this does is it in a way echoes the organic streets which you find in any Indian city. You know, this is a very typical thing that you go straight and you can look straight all the way. But here, you go till here, you don't see the end and the road turns. So in the sense, this is the pathway. And all of these are large garden spaces. So this is all garden. So the gardens all face the north and that's very important. So at the same time, it faces the north and it faces the playground. And this is the southern side. Sun is always in the southern hemisphere. So simply by locating these things, one is you created organic. There's a character to each one of these units, so you don't feel that there's anything repetition that is going on. At the same time, the orientation is such that all of these hostel rooms start looking towards the playground and are north oriented, so which reduces the heat gain. So while we created this organic layout, we also realized that this is going to result the same way into hostel rooms facing each other. We thought that how will you create every single room to actually face this playground when you are going as per the site and building kind of in a way parallel to the site boundaries. So in detail, when you look at this plan, there is a central corridor and all these are hostel rooms on either side. But as opposed to most of their hostel rooms earlier built and what most people build also, every time the corridor takes a bend, there is an open space here. So this becomes like a breakout zone. And then, because we wanted this north orientation and we wanted that there should be no overlooking from hostel to hostel, at the same time, every room should get a look of that playground, we've done bay windows like this. So now, when a student is in this hostel room, he looks out first at this immediate garden. And then, further beyond, as a focal, he looks at that main cricket playground of the whole university. Simultaneously, this being the north, you have no heat from the south. So one of the most important things we achieved in this was the whole organic feel of the entire campus of these student hostels. If you look at their existing hostels, Wherever you stand, the view is identical. You see these two blocks, which are pure rectangles. The perspective goes, that's one, that's the other. 100% maths, and you can keep on repeating this. But now, when you see what we've done, you see this. It tapers, then it bends further. On the opposite side, you see another one. Again, that tapers, again, that goes back. So you actually don't see the end. And then you see a tree here. So this is the kind of feeling. Everything then becomes organic, and then you have these bay windows. And then for all the public facilities, which include the mess and the gym, we made really large 24 feet high volumes where people can sit. Again, these form the focal points of looking out at the playground. So even the gym has a terrace which looks at the playground. The mess opens up directly into the playground. And you get these kind of compositions wherever you walk through, and they're constantly differing. At no point in this complex is there a repetition of the kind of space that you get. So in addition to being really fast, we had a very, very strict time frame. The entire building had to be finished in 6 months. So we've kept all the materials very, very simple. All the buildings are finished in stucco plaster. It's just paint. And there's color that actually defines each different hostel. So again, going back to the point of how all their earlier hostels are completely repetitive in nature, here each hostel block has a different color, very subtly, in the soffit of the window only. So when you're walking past, you realize, okay, the one with the red is my block, the one with the blue is my friend's block, the one with the yellow is friend's block, for example. Inside also, it's all very simple tile flooring, painted walls, there's no expensive material used anywhere. And because of this, we were able to achieve it in time. So we only use color as a very strong element, as a very strong graphic element. It defines the building separately. It creates an identity for each one. Even in the gym and the mess and all of the internal spaces, it's just color that helps in defining spaces and lending it character. While we were making this, in fact, construction had already started, and we kept telling the client, please tell us how many of these hostels you're going to get air conditioned. So he said, what you do is 50% we will air condition and 50% we won't air condition. So every week when we would go to site, I would try to explain them that please don't do this, do one thing. So he finally agreed that we will air condition the entire hostels, all 800 rooms. The AC units were ordered, piping was done. But the AC units had not yet arrived when the students came in to occupy the campus during the start of the semester. When students occupied, it was May, the maximum heat that is there in Mathura. And students found that there was no cooling required. So the AC order was actually cancelled. And that just goes to show that if you design in a sensible way, you know, your whole building is energy efficient. So you straight away cut off 27% of energy just by orientation.